Hey, it's John from Enduring Charm. I want to describe today how I'm going to handle a particular detail on some cabinets that I'm making. As you can see, these kitchen cabinets are, the carcasses are getting done, and I have a whole bunch more on the other side of the shop. And what I'm up to now is I need to do the face frames, which is a traditional way of doing things. So I need to apply those face frames to the edges of these carcasses that I've already built. And one thing I want to do on the edges of that face frame is to apply this bead detail, which is again a traditional detail that you see. So anywhere where there's a drawer or a door, and these drawers and doors are going to be inset, then this edge will have that bead detail. Now, one traditional way of doing that is just to build the face frame with square edges and then on separate wood cut the bead detail and then apply it as if you would apply a moulding on every edge. So you'd miter the corners and apply each one. And there's nothing wrong with that. But I'd like to try something else today, and this is just a mock-up I'm doing, I'm in the middle of. But what I'm gonna do is use a special router bit that does this part for me, and I'm gonna get to that in a minute. And then I'll apply the bead detail directly to the face frame on either edge, and then miter the edges, and that should fit in together. And that is a little bit of a stronger detail, I think, than the traditional way of applying this bead as if it were a molding. But how do you get to all this? Well, I'm gonna go over that today. It is somewhat advanced, so I'm not gonna go over every single detail. I'm assuming you do have a router table, you know how to use a router and that kind of thing. So let's get to what I'm doing here. Right over here on my router table, I'm gonna show you what this bit looks like. It's made by Craig. K-R-E-G, and there is, I think, some offerings from other manufacturers as well, but this was the easiest for me to find. I think I got this on Amazon, believe it or not. So basically, this router bit on the top area right here has a flat part of the blade, and then this angle part of the blade is a 45. So when it's spinning and you pass the piece of wood through, you're going to get a profile like that. Now, I had cut this bead area already. Now, this is just a scrap piece because I was trying to get through trial and error my correct alignment. But once the bead is cut, you can use that to make sure you get this flat spot, which is just where the flat part of the wood starts. So this bit is what you need. Craig sells an elaborate jig to help you do or handle this very problem, but it's expensive and I'm cheap and I figured I could do this a different way. So once you have this bit, I'm going to describe now how I'm going to try to handle this. All right, this is the basic setup on the router table. I have a miter gauge in a slot, which is going to move back and forth. What I'm going to want to cut is this edge right here. Okay, again, this is just a piece of scrap right now. And we have the bit height correct as far as I can figure. So I've already used trial and error to get that height correct. Now my next problem is I need to locate this area of relief correctly on each stile, because the rail is going to go in there and I need to know where on the stile, if this is the stile, where that's going to be. So what I decided to do was mark the center, which you can see I did here on the back, the center of the relief that's cut by the router bit. So from this edge to this edge, not the angled part, but just the flat part, it's 1.5 inches. So half of that is 3/4, of course. So that's where my mark is. So it's dead center in this area right here. And then I just put a piece of tape on the table and I marked that line. So now I can find, this is dead center of the router bit. So when I move this forward, I'm gonna go right over the router bit, come back, I'm dead center there. So you see how that's working. Now, once I have that in place, I can put a new workpiece on here. And if I have marked the center of where I want the rail to go on the stile, and I put that center on this line, that means I should be lined up correctly. All right, you'll have to forgive the shadows here. Hello. Over here on my workbench, I can kind of describe better what I'm after here. So here's some of the drawings, the shop drawings I have for the cabinets that I'm making. And I know from my drawings where I need to be as far as the rails and the stiles. So in this case, there's a 2-inch rail, there's a 4-inch space, and another 2-inch rail. And then the door, and then a 2-inch rail on the bottom. The stile, which is what we need to cut with the new router bit, I need to locate those relief areas for the rails at particular points. So it's easy to mark on the rails and style, on the stiles, I should say, where I need to be. So here's my 2-inch rail up top. Here's my 4-inch space. Here's my next 2-inch rail. And I'm going to explain something about that shortly. And then all I need to do then is mark the center of where that rail is. Once I've done that, I can use this test piece that I did earlier. And again, I marked the center of that test piece. And now I can hold this up to where I need to be. See if I can get that on camera. And you can see all I did was mark the center of where I need to be. So that works out pretty easily. Now, one thing I need to describe, the router bit, this area right here, the minimum for this particular bit is 1.5 inches. Now, I think they do make a smaller one, but this happens to be the one I bought, and it's going to work out all right for me. But when I originally designed these face frames, I had a 2-inch rail here. Well, as it works out, I'd made that design before I had the router bit. As it works out, it's actually a little bit more than 2 inches. It's about 2 3/16, maybe even a little strong, for a rail width in order to meet the 1.5 inches here, all right? So what I'm ending up doing is my opening is gonna be slightly smaller. It's not really a big deal for me, but it is something to think about. And up here on the top, I can keep my 2-inch rail height because, or width I should say, because I can make the center basically right there. This top part doesn't matter because it's, you know, this is the top of the cabinet right here. Same thing on the bottom. You know, you just need me to be aware if you want a wider rail, that's fine. But if you want a narrower than 2 3/16 in my case, that's a problem. So just be aware when you buy the router bit, this measurement matters. You can always make the relief area that you're cutting bigger than what the router bit provides, but you can't make it smaller, obviously. So that's all I'm doing here is I'm taking this scrap piece that I used and I cut as a test fit. And once I got that test fit correct, I marked the center. And now I can use that center mark to locate where these relief cuts need to be. All right, back over here at my router table, these are the actual stiles that I'll be cutting. And you can see I made my mark. You can see that, there it is. I made my mark, the center points of where that relief cut needs to be made. All I have to do now is line up that center point of the relief cut with the center point of the bit that I marked on this piece of tape. Then I'm just going to use, I clamp that all in place. I'm going to use my miter gauge and run this through, and that'll give me perfect alignment. Now, I am cutting two styles side by side at the same time, and you could probably do more. I'm doing that because I want to make sure these align correctly. In fact, I have four to cut. I should probably set them all up. But in any case, you could do more than one at a time and make sure the alignment is correct that way. So I'll try to put this on a tripod and show you the cut. All right, so there's my relief cut, the first one. I'll make another one up here and another one on the bottom. And then these two stiles will be done. Now, one thing I also should note is I have not yet cut the beads. And I did that on purpose because I want to be able to have freedom of orientation when I'm cutting these styles so that, you know, if I need to flip it one way or the other or whatever, I don't really have to worry about it. So I'm cutting the relief cuts first. And then I'll cut the beads later, and that way there's no mix-ups as far as which side the bead is cut on, that kind of thing. Just makes life easier for me. So that's basically the setup. I'm not going to go into too much more detail here. Basically, if you have the bit that's correct, you're good to go. You do some test fitting, make sure the height is correct. Then you're just going to use this tape to mark the center, like I did with using the back of an existing relief cut that you make or test cut that you make. Once you mark that center, you're going to use a test piece of rail to mark on the stiles where you want the rail to meet. you mark that center, you line up the two centers, run it through, and you're done. All right, as I start to do the face frame here, I just wanted to give you a shot of what it looks like. This joint fits together pretty well. You can fine tune it a little bit, like this one I may fine tune ever so slightly. This is not put together yet, it's just sitting there. I'm gonna use pocket screws on the back side of this. I do have a video about that if you've never used pocket screws. Then I'll nail through into the plywood edge here. So it seems to be working pretty well. Once you get the dimensions right, it's pretty easy to mark your centers and then go from there. I did do the bead now. This bottom part doesn't have one, this part does. So saving that bead till after you do the relief cut here, I think does make it easier just because it's less confusing. And now on this center area here, I need to actually make a relief cut on the rail here and here, but I like to put it all together and mark it when it's in place so I have no issues as far as lining up with the existing carcass. I just want to do one last follow-up here. So I'm starting to do more of these cabinets, and the face frames are getting more complicated. Like this one has a drawer. This is another one I was doing before that has multiple doors and drawers. I am noticing one thing, which is it may be easier in some cases to mark not just the center line, which hopefully you can see here, but the outside edges as well. And then when you have a rail, for example, that's wider than what this bit provides, you need to make two passes in order to make that wider width. So by marking the edges of the router bit, like I've done here, that allows you to move the rail side to side to make each pass, and that may make things easier. So what I'm ending up with is a combination. Sometimes I use the center marks, sometimes I use the outside marks, depending on the size of the rail, or the relief, I should say, for the rail that I'm cutting. So depending on what you're doing, you may want to mark all those edges. Other than that, though, the system is working very well, and I'm very pleased with the way it's coming out.